Hello friends, very good morning, very good afternoon. Today we are going to see Facebook using which database. So let's start. As you know, most of the people are using the Facebook, correct? And as per the stats, 2.93 billion monthly active users means they are using the Facebook. And 36.7 of the world population uses the Facebook monthly. And 70% of the internet users are active on at least one meta platform. The company owns Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger. Who's that company? Meta platform. And who is the CEO of that? Mark Zuckerberg. And over 1 billion stories are posted every day across the Facebook application. So you can means you know how the Facebook uses, and 67% monthly users are active daily, and facebook.com is the third most visited website in the world. Means we are surfing the website at that time. This is the third website in the world, and in this graph you will get the complete user count, means who's application is used by number of users. Means suppose YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, what's Facebook Messenger, TikTok. So how much billion users? Means as you see, there is a Facebook is 2.8 or 2.9 billion users are using this Facebook. And the next question, which type of data are available on the Facebook? Yes, obviously numeric, text, image, audio, video. Then we can share the file over the Facebook Messenger, and there is a story we can post. Then there are lots of images, lots of videos are available on the Facebook. So let's see in detail. When we have to consider the powerful storage or performance or in terms of the powerful system, at that time we need to consider different factors, means different parameters based on the data, means data like structured data, like the users, user information, means first name, last name, middle name, where it born, what is the birth date, what is the passport of him, then all the things related to him, like education, then he is married or not married, and there are some setting, means profile related setting, means that profile is visible to others or friends or not visible to others. And there is a groups, means group is having a multiple users, and there is a friends, means one user having a n number of friends. So that information is a structured information. And there is a like, suppose I like one picture, at that time there is a like count will increase, correct? So these are the structured data. And unstructured data, it means there is a video, audio, images. So this is the unstructured data. And distributed system, actually distributed system, it means suppose one copy, one video is copied to the different system, means multiple system. So such a system is known as a distributed system, means one copy at multiple places. What it does actually in background, it create the multiple copies in terms of the disaster recovery, high availability solution. And one more thing, means suppose there is a HDFS system, Hadoop distributed file system, in that we have to gather all the files at one location, or one file is distributed in a multiple chunks, and that file again gather at one place and we are showing to the user. So this is nothing but the distributed system is come into the picture. Actually I will create a one separate session on the distributed system and scalable system, so that you will get complete understanding over on these different terms. And cluster is nothing but the set of computers, means we, in that there is a primary server, secondary server, then there is a read-only replica. So that combination is known as a cluster. Scalability of the system means, suppose here is the one server, and on one server there is a data is increasing massively, means n number of video, millions and billions of video images you have to store. So what you will do, you will add the RAM, processing, hard disks, but at certain situation means database burden is growing continuously and one time it will crash, correct? Means there is a certain limit. So instead of that, what you can do, there is a scalable system, means multiple servers at one data center in one cluster, so that they are connected to each other, means like differentiated with the parent node, child node, or a name node, data node, and they are connected with the help of network, and we can add the power to the particular processing, means instead of one, we can add one more machine at here. So it is the scalability, means if we required to add, if there is a lot of load on this cluster, then we can add the processing power, add the hard disks to it, and we can scale it out, correct? Obviously storage is required, correct? If we have to store the large number of images, videos, then we require the large storage, correct? And performance, why performance is matter? Yeah, we can store the n numbers of video, images, audio, and if our performance is get decreed, then what will be the output? Nothing. So if we are logging to this Facebook, at that time we are getting all the data in a fraction of second when we are scrolling the video at that time, correct? So that is nothing but the performance and speed. Means that system should be a performant, and that system having a speed as well. Okay, let's see what are the different databases are using by the Facebook in detail. Facebook, you having the one of the biggest data center in the world called as Facebook Leo data center, which having all the data, means like the images, video, audio, structured information, unstructured information, all these things. So this is the peak of the particular data center of the Facebook, and Facebook uses the combination of technologies to keep the track of users and their data, correct? And the company uses the variety of databases to store the different data, like MySQL, Cassandra, memcached, HDFS, Hive. So these are the some different technologies they are using. And as you know, there is a Meta. Meta is the complete platform for WhatsApp, then Facebook, Facebook Messenger, and Instagram. And they are having all the data is in one data center, correct? Actually, there are different data centers and they are connected to each other. And this is the user, means they are user is logging to the Facebook with the help of application, laptop, means Facebook application with the help of desktop, laptop, or a mobile. And this is the screen. With the help of that, they can connect to the Facebook world, correct? And so let's see in detail. MySQL. MySQL is the relational database management system, correct? So it's storing the structured data like user profile, post, and comment. Facebook uses Apache Cassandra, or distributed NoSQL database, to store and retrieve large amount of data across the multiple servers. And next one is the memcached. Memcached is the in-memory data caching system to speed up and retrieval of the data from the different databases, and it is used to cache the MySQL as well as general purpose cache, and 300 TB of data is stored in memcached. Facebook uses Hadoop, correct? So it is open source framework for storing and processing big data. Big data means large amount of data, unstructured data we can say. And there is images, video, audio, and where they are stored, HDFS means Hadoop distributed file system. And next one is Hive, or data warehousing technology. It is used for to analyze the data. And next one is the TAO, the association and objects. I think you heard about the name of the databases. There is a graph database. In that, there are different nodes are connected to each other. Suppose I am at here and B is my friend, and B having their friends like the D. So I can send requests to directly D, or D can send requests to me. Actually, that is in the suggestions box we are getting. My suggestion pop up. Yeah, there are some different friends on the screen, and you can connect to him, or D can send the request to A. Means there is a relationship between the A to D or D to A. In this relationship, there is a B's act as a mutual friend, and so that suppose A is getting the request from D, or D is getting the request from A, then in that request B will act as a mutual friend, and so that we can easily identify. Conclusion is, Facebook using the technologies like the MySQL as a database, Cassandra, then memcached, then Hadoop HDFS storage, then there is a Hive. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you really like it, this video, then please give me a one like on this video and share it so that other will know, and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.